So students, myself Chitraj Sharma. I am assistant professor faculty of pharmaceutical science at Sam Dawson University. So today I am going to discuss about the small volume parenterals. Okay? So come with the second part of the small volume parenterals. So let's discuss with the small volume parenterals. So students, I am discussing about the small volume parenterals. Okay. So small volume parenterals. These are mainly the volume is generally less than or equal to 100 ml. Okay, so those parenteral preparations, their volume is less than or equal to 100 ml. There, that means it is a small volume parenterals. Okay, so they are supplied in a single or multiple dose, or they are used to dispense most of the drugs. Okay, so we are using lots of formulations as a small volume parenterals. So examples are samples and vials. Okay. So what is the type of mainly small volume parenterals? These are included, that is solution, suspension, emulsion, and dry powders. So first come with the solutions. So solutions are typically used for delivering medications controlled infusion rate. Okay. So most common solutions of mainly 5% dextrose, normal saline, 45% normal saline, or 5% dextrose with normal saline. So these are the mainly examples of solutions we are using as a small volume parenterals. Now dextrose contributes glucose to meet energy needs, and saline contributes sodium and electrolyte that maintains fluid balance and cellular functions. So that is mainly the balancing the electrolyte of our body system. So next come with the suspension. So they should be sterile or pyrogen free, stable and resuspendable, syringeable, injectable, isotonic and non-irritating. So these are the main criteria when we are going for the small volume parenterals as a suspension. Okay, it should be pyrogen free, it should be sterile, it should be stable and resuspendable and syringeable. Okay, that means the particulate size of the suspension is very, that means fine. Okay, otherwise it cannot be syringeable and injectable. Okay, so they are usually administered by the either subcutaneous route or intramuscular route. Okay, so these suspensions usually contain between 0.5% and 5% solids. Okay, should have particle size less than 5 micrometer for intramuscular route or subcutaneous. Yes, administration. So mainly example, certain antibiotic preparations, that is for example procaine, penicillin G, may contain up to 30% of solids. So advantages of parenteral suspension, what is the advantage? Main advantages are, it is better for the therapeutic use of drugs that are insoluble in convenient solutions. Okay, those drugs are convenient in that means some solvents, and we can prepare as a suspension. So these doses forms, there is a increased resistance to hydrolysis or oxidation as a drug is present in the solid. Okay, when it is in solid form, it is the high resistance. Okay, some drugs are mainly prone to the hydrolysis and oxidation. Okay, so when it is in suspension form, it is have the higher tendency for the resistance of oxidation and hydrolysis. So when we are going for the control release formulation, so in this case, when we are preparing the parenteral suspension, we are using as a control release dose. So there is an elimination of hepatic phosphorus effect. Okay, so these are the main advantages of parenteral suspensions. Next come with the injectable emulsions. So what is emulsion? Emulsion is a heterogeneous dispersion of one immiscible liquid in another. That means it is two phases. One is oil phase, another one is water phase. Okay, so this inherently unstable system is made possible through use of emulsifiers. Okay, you cannot mix oil and water simply. Can you? You can. But with the help of emulsifying agent, you can prepare the emulsion, you can mix with the all the boiling water. So, which prevent the coalescence after dispersed droplet. By preventing the coalescence, we can prepare the emulsions. So, parenteral emulsions are mainly rare because it is necessary and difficult to achieve the stable drop. Okay? For less than 1 micron to prevent embolic or blood vessels, and it is not usually necessary to achieve an emulsion for drug administration.